Hello, everyone. I'm here with the star of the broadcast, Ludo. Everyone loves Ludo. Ludo is the best. I hope you had a great week. Oh, there goes Ludo. See you later. I have to share with you, honestly, an experience that I had this week. Some weeks are certainly harder than others, and surely you've encountered this too in your lives. Let me back up a step to 2002. Part of the formation for being a priest in the Diocese of Albany is the clinical pastoral education. Now, we don't do that anymore, but that was between the years 1999 and 2005. CPE was one summer of intense ministerial training, either in a prison or in a hospital. I did my training at Berkshire Medical Center in Pittsfield, just over the border. It was a great experience. What a great summer, not just for visiting the patients, but learning about my own interactions with patients and people. But our group of individuals that were in the program for CPE, we really bonded as a family, and not just Catholic seminarians, but Lutheran seminarians, Episcopalian, all different denominations, Church of Christ, etc. The eight of us really became close, like a small family. Every year, we would gather in reunion in December at the Red Lion Inn in Stockbridge, also just over the border near the Divine Mercy Shrine. We'd get together there at the Red Lion for lunch, and we'd reminisce about how the past year in our ministries has gone. And so, fast forward to Monday of this past week. I received an email message on Monday morning that one of the members of our little CPE family died unexpectedly due to a bilateral pulmonary embolism. Now, I am no doctor. I have no idea what that involves, but it sounds pretty major and pretty serious. But our dear friend, Karen Safstrom, served the Episcopalian and Lutheran communities in central Massachusetts. I was struck when I read this, and I could not believe what I was reading, first of all. And then just sickened by the news that someone in their mid-40s could so suddenly fall asleep with no notice. May she rest in peace. And so I offer this little tribute in her memory, but for all of us who have lost someone so sudden and without notice, without any chance to say goodbye, without any opportunity for reconciliation for the past, this is life. Every breath is a precious gift from the good Lord. Don't ever take it for granted. Maybe some of you are watching with family around you now, streaming in or tuning on Sunday morning at 9 o'clock, watching this as the introduction to our Mass. If the Mass is about memory, then the experience of the friends and family God has given us is a true opportunity for grace to be able to grow as disciples. And that means deeper in our own faith, honest in who we have been before God. But don't ever let life pass by without an opportunity to say what needs to be said. We do not know if we go to sleep tonight, if we will wake up tomorrow. Our lives are in the hands of the good Lord. Jesus teaches us to fear no one, and we are never afraid. And so, although our hearts are sick sometimes and are saddened, we know that God cares for us and is near. And I'm not saying that just to say it. I know that as a statement of my own belief, in my own feeling that Jesus is near, that no matter what will happen, we'll be okay, even if it means that we won't be able to say hello anymore to someone in our group of friends, ministerial colleagues, or family who was very close to us. So may those who have fallen asleep rest in peace, and the good Lord will aid us through any time of trial. So be not afraid, And I hope, as you tune into today's Mass, to understand the gift of Jesus by the people he has placed in your lives and to never take them for granted. Take good care, everybody. He's the real star of the show. There he is. He loves the shade. He's not moving out of the shade.